Welcome back, everybody. Bringing back the nostalgia of old photos with her DIY instant photo keychains is Maria.
Yay!
All those instant photos are so fun,
and I am a newly made soccer/baseball mom. And so one of these things that I loved about these pictures is that it's sort of like a brag book that you can take with you everywhere. And so when you get the pictures during soccer and baseball and things like that, they usually come on like a little pin.
Yeah.
Well, now you can put it on your keychains, and it's something that you can carry with you everywhere. And so I love this. It doesn't have to just be for kids, but you can put like a group of your girlfriends or your dogs or like, you know, we have these adorable pictures here, like that one of Mark and his boys. Aww. I have one of Debbie and your mom, and I have one with you and Alexandra.
Oh
yes, and we actually, it's this one right here. I have the adorable one.
Oh, that was just a freaky smile.
Left it plain so you can write on it if you want.
I love that one that you picked of mine because that's their very first concert.
Oh, so you can write that. See, that's what's cool. It's a way to commemorate all
these
things
for the memories. So what do we need to make this besides your favorite trusty clay? I'm glad we brought the clay back. Yeah. I've missed the clay for a
minute. Wait, really? The intervention didn't work?
It did not. It made it worse. So the clay, oven-baked clay, which is what we have here, and then we have these split rings of just some different sizes, and then some cornstarch, and I will tell you why cornstarch or baby powder you could use as well, and then a gloss to cover it. There's a couple different kinds. I have like a Sculpey one or a Mod Podge, but you want it to be a gloss finish.
Okay.
And then a paintbrush, ruler, and then something to cut with. I like just using, this is like a craft knife. I don't use it in my kitchen anymore. And then kind of your odds and ends, like scissors and the rolling pin.
And the rolling pin. All right. So what do we do?
Okay. So you start with said clay. So I just am using white because I want to do that sort of traditional look for this. So actually what I'm doing here, I work on a covered surface just because it's easier to peel it away if you need to. But you roll it in between your hands and just to kind of get it so it's warmed up. And then I put it on the cornstarch because what it does is it's similar to cookies in the sense that
keeps it from sticking.
Yes, exactly.
Oh.
And so
put a little more maybe.
Yeah. You know what I need? I need it on here.
Here, on the rolling pin. There you go.
Well,
okay.
But it's not sticking anywhere now. Trust me. There you go.
Okay, maybe not that much.
But look, it's not sticking.
But look, it's not sticking.
It is not.
There you go.
So then you roll it out. Yes, you roll it out so it's about a quarter of an inch thick. And then so I will have all these measurements for you. On our website. And there it's, but what it is, because you can vary the sizes, but it's about 2 inches one way and 1 3/4 inch another way. So you just take your little ruler here. And I have one already, I'm going to swap it out here because I have one already pre-measured so you guys can see. And I just use my knife to do this.
Dare I say this would be a cool thing to put in a stocking stuffer?
That would be, of course.
I mean, I know we've got Christmas corner for stuff like, but this is, I just thought of this. I'm like, what a cool homemade gift.
And you know what? You can change the colors as well, but I think it's a great gift. I love doing brag books for anything. And like I said, if you have a dog, you could do it for your dog or anything like that. So I use an X-Acto knife right here, and I just make a little indentation, and then I put in, this is a 9 millimeter little split ring. And then I put it in.
Could
just
you use an eye hook?
So you could. Yeah. So basically anything that's gonna like hook or stay in there, and I'm gonna lift it up so you can see. So it looks like that.
Okay.
Oh my gosh, look at my hands.
And it's gonna it's gonna dry that way.
And so then what you do, what you wanna do from this point now is to put it on a cookie sheet. I like to line mine just with some parchment paper, and you pop this in the oven according to whatever the package says for the clay that you buy.
Okay. So
they could all be different. Generally speaking, it's about a quarter inch. It's about 15 minutes at 275 degrees.
Okay.
So kind of like a low and slow situation.
Okay. Can I do a spin-off here?
Yes.
Could you use like a cookie cutter and do like a heart?
Oh my gosh.
Of course. If you didn't want to do like that sort of, we wanted to do like that sort of
traditional instant photo,
but you could do anything you want.
Adorable.
It's a really fun.
Spitballing. All I'm doing is spitballing.
You got more?
I got more.
What else could you do?
That'd be Valentine's Day.
Right?
You could do little Christmas tree ones.
Sure. Halloween.
You could do a paw for a dog. All kinds of things.
Okay, this is just, use your creative judgment.
It goes on and on.
On and.
Stepped on a creative.
And you know what else you could do? You could use these as like for if you were having a what's it called, a baby shower or something, and these would be gifts for everybody.
Exactly. You could be taking pictures that day, and you can print them out. And actually, it's like a little.
You don't like that idea? Well, okay.
Okay, but this is why I love the clay, because we went from something that's like literally like you know like this.
No, it's nothing.
To like. to that. And, by the way, durable.
Is it heavy though?
No, it hangs on there really light, just almost like any other adornment you would put on to your keys.
Okay, and now we gloss.
Yes, now we gloss. So what I said over here, we have like a gloss, like the Mod Podge gloss finish. It comes in a matte. Go for the gloss. But there's like there's other options. But just go for like a glossy type of glaze. And this is how you can just glue on your picture as well. So what you want to do is, like I said, the sizes for both of these are going to be on our website if you want exactly what we did. Mm-hmm. So what you want is your picture to be a little bit smaller. So I do this, and then I place the picture. You want it to be obviously smaller, and you could cut this down even a little bit too if you wanted it to fit.
So you're making it like a frame?
So, just like a, yeah, and just like the little like instant pictures that, you know, you take it in and pop out.
Yeah.
And then once you dry it, or once you let it dry,
wait,
I would go over it.
Is that how small the pictures were?
Yeah, so we just printed these out on like the photo paper.
Oh, I see.
You could just
print
them out on regular ones. I have this one of you guys, which
I
think is
hilarious.
Oh, I
remember that.
Oh, yeah.
And you just put your giant split ring on there, and then you're done.
Just like
that.
Just like that.
Now you painted it though.
This one was pink.
What, pink clay?
Pink clay.
Oh.
Look.
Could you paint them as well?
Yeah, you could paint them.
Oh, I love
so
that.
With the white, sometimes it can change color with your hands, and you can make it really white by painting.
Sure.
And that would be perfect for your Valentine's Day. Mother's Day's right around
Mother's
the corner.
Mother's Day's coming up.
We could do them for Mother's Day.
Yes. Greg, look.
Father's Day.
That already happened, but we could.
Oh, and then write on, if you want to write on, use just like a permanent marker or paint pen.